It began with this man, Carter G. Woodson, a historian and writer. Woodson noticed that his people were, quote, overlooked, ignored, and even suppressed by the writers of history textbooks and the teachers who use them, end quote. So he started a Black History Week in 1926, and people celebrated it enthusiastically. They started Black History Clubs, and teachers started recognizing the contributions of Black Americans in their classrooms. He chose February, by the way, because it held the birthdays of both Abraham Lincoln and Frederick Douglass, two men he believed had done tremendous work for the rights and liberties of African Americans. It took another 50 years, though, for Black History Month to become officially recognized by our government. The president at the time, Gerald Ford, said that we should seize the opportunity to honor the two often neglected accomplishments of Black Americans in every area of endeavor throughout our history. Here's the funny thing, though. Carter G. Woodson hoped that someday people would no longer celebrate Black History Month. He saw the day when it would no longer be necessary, when finally we would see Black history in America for what it really is, an essential part of American history.